A proud Albertan. A proud Calgarian. A proud supporter of horse racing in Alberta. Today, the late Premier is honored in the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake, featuring the top three-year-old fillies, led by elimination winners, the Jim Marino surprise contender, Wrapped to Go, as well as Kelly Horde's latest star, That's Extra. But first, a Canadian Hall of Fame breeder is feted as the three-year-old boys pace for cash in the Brad Gunn Stake. Winner of seven of his last eight races, the Keith Clark conditioned first-class horse is sure to go off as the favorite. Horse racing and the standardbreds are back in Calgary. Next.
Alberta's a horse province, and racing's been here for a long, long time.
Wait for it, it'll come.
I love to race in Calgary, so it's just great to have it back again.
To have horse racing back in Calgary means everything to this province.
Wait for it, the morning sun.
Southern Alberta is ag country. Southern Alberta is horse racing country.
Standard racing, to me, second to none.
It's not a job, no. It's a way of life.
I love it. I love the thrill of it. I love sitting in a bike.
Just all about winning races. It's a competition, and you never get tired of that.
It's not even about the money. It's just about crossing the finish line first and getting that rush.
That's the drug. You have to win. It's like anybody coaching or playing professional sports. They play to win. You don't play to finish second.
Soon again we ride.
There's nothing like sitting behind a real good horse when you pull him out of the hole and yanks you ahead. The thrills they give you, you never forget.
Horses, once they're in your blood, they're in your blood. I mean, you just can't go a day without them, unfortunately.
The animals, as tough as animals can be, I don't care what anybody says, no race, it seems like forever. So the animal itself impresses the hell out of me.
To have this new racetrack back in Calgary, it's lightning for a guy.
It just means everything to everybody in horse racing, that's for sure.
Sensory Downs really was the savior.
Savior.
Savior. Lifesaver for all of us.
It's pretty much like a dream come true to me. You know, we're back where we're supposed to be.
Soon again we ride. Soon again we ride.
Good afternoon and welcome to the beautiful Century Downs Racetrack and Casino here in sunny southern Alberta. We invite you to join us here for the next hour as we celebrate a very special day. Here today we feature our inaugural industry broadcast as well as one of the biggest days on the Alberta Standardbreds racing calendar. Here today we'll cheer on some of the finest three-year-olds in Western Canada in the prestigious Brad Gunn as well as the sentimental favorite, the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stakes. And here to guide us through the next hour of excitement, it's my pleasure to welcome one of the foremost horse racing experts in the country, the lovely Don Lupel.
Thank you so much, Crystal. It is a personal honor for me to be sitting here at Century Downs, just outside of Calgary. It's been a long time coming, and you're going to hear the story throughout this afternoon. It is such a blessing to have racing back in Calgary, and what a great way to kick it off here in 2015 with the Brad Gunn and the Ralph Klein Stakes, two very important stakes named after two incredible men. You need to follow along with us. You have to get your program pages, and to do so, go to thehorses.com. You can download your own program information and pick the horses that you like, and statistical information courtesy of Track It. We have a jam-packed show for you today, and right now the horses are leaving the barn for the Brad Gunn Stakes. This race for three-year-old colts and geldings, they are competing for $90,000. No eliminations required for this race. Nine of them will line up to get this race, the Brad Gunn Stakes, the honors for this. Kisses all around, and we're going to take a nice close look at all of these horses. Before we start, I'll let you know, we want to watch the time because the weather is perfect here in Balzac, just north of Calgary, for track record performances. The three-year-old Colton Gelding track record is 154. 4-1, and that was set by First Class Horse, who is in this race. The overall track record, 152-3. That is how they will line up. Have Not Read It from the inside with flying colors to the outside, nine of them, and there is First Class Horse. That will be the favorite, and he starts today from post number 6 for Keith Clark, who trains and drives. Interesting configuration here at Century Downs. It is not a 1 mile track. It is an 11/16 mile track, which is 5.5 furlongs, so a rather distinctively laid out surface for the horses. Strictly standardbreds this year. Thoroughbred racing is going to be added for 2016. Final preparations handling now, and here is number 1, Have Not Read It, coming out onto the track. Kelly Hort training and driving this son of Dragon again. Only 3 American breds in this field. The rest of them are all Alberta breds. 7-1, breeder Flintlock Farm of Pennsylvania, and earnings of $25,000, a mark of 156-4. This colt race timed in 154-2 just 2 starts ago. Kind of heady circumstances for Have Not Read It. He just broke his maiden 4 starts ago in the middle of June, so he's looking to become a stakes performer here. Number 2, Chillin' Like a Villain. Gotta love that name. Kelly Hort, also the trainer on this one. He's handed the lines to the very capable horseman, Bill Teange Jr. Couple of wins on the form for Chillin' Like a Villain this year. Couldn't get untracked last year as a 2-year-old. This son of Brandon's Cowboy. Coming a nice half mile in his last start, 58-4. He's going to get a good trip today from that post position too. Here's a look at number 3, Outlaw Deacon Jim. Paul Davies in the bike, trainer Rod Hennessy sending that capable young horseman out. This is a son of Blue Burner, who has had a sensational 3-year-old season so far. 4 wins from 9 starts. He's paced to his lifetime best of 156-1, race timed in 55-4 in his most recent outing. This horse is versatile. He can go to the front. He can also close from off of the pace. Very confident young horseman Brandon Campbell swinging into the bike. He will drive number 4, You Are Cut Off, trained by Daryl Cutting. You Are Cut Off, owned by the American Mark Anderson from California, a longtime supporter of Western Canadian horse racing. You Are Cut Off had a sensational 2-year-old season with 5 wins from 8 starts. A little sluggish this year so far, just 1 win so far on the card, but he paced a big mile last time out in 156-4, finally getting a good draw. He's been drawing a series of outside post positions. He's perfectly positioned on the gate today from post 4. There's JF Gagné, Jean-Francois Gagné. He's been out in Western Canada many, many years now. This is another Daryl Cutting trainee, the 5, Pablo's First. Pablo's First coming off a 4th place finish, JF Gagné in the bike on that day. This horse with a couple of wins so far this year, he's quick enough to compete with this field. He's going to be one of the moderately priced horses, not the longest shot, but certainly not a favorite. He offers a little bit of value on the tote board. Again, this horse in good form right now. There's the man. When you speak of Western Canadian harness racing, Keith Clark is the name that comes to everyone's minds. He trains and drives number 6 First Class Horse. This horse has had a sensational record so far. 7-8 so far this year, 12-15 lifetime. He is the 3-year-old colt track record holder, pacing to a win in the Gordon Rumpel Stakes in June in 154-1. Finished 3rd to older horses in his most recent start, but with an eye-catching 54-1 last half, a mile and 53-4. Jim Marino, just happy to be in the bike anywhere. He had a tough year so far, and we'll talk about that in a while. Here's number 7, Johnny Gunn, trained by Harold Haining. Johnny Gunn was sent off as the favorite in his most recent start, ended up finishing 2nd, but was an upset winner of the Alberta Plainsman back on July the 12th, right here at Century Downs, pacing to a mile of 156, his lifetime best so far. We'll get to number 8, My Sharona Blue Chip. This is another American bred in this field. The son of Rock and Roll Heaven, Jerry Houdon, takes the lines from trainer Keith Clark. My Sharona Blue Chip, challenging post position today from post 8. His biggest strength would have to be his speed. Jerry Houdon's a speed driver too, so going to have to get My Sharona Blue Chip interested in the early going to have any chance of picking up part of this $90,000 purse here this afternoon. And finally, here comes number 9 with flying colors, with Phil Giesbrecht in the bike. Originally from Manitoba, he was out east for a while in Ontario, and now out west with flying colors showing his heels to the crowd here. Keith Clark, the trainer on this one. Keith sending out three horses in this race, but of course he will drive the favorite first class horse with flying colors. 0 for 11 so far this year, but with 10 finishes in the top three. That is a look at the field for the Brad Gunn Stakes. Again, $90,000 on the line. And there's a good look at Jim Marino. Jim Marino going to guide the 7, Johnny Gunn, today. Again, we discussed it. Jim involved in a horrific accident earlier this year. So for him to be back in the bike means so much for him. Kind of a renewing of acquaintances here, because here is You Are Cut Off. Brandon Campbell in the bike, a very good, solid driver is Brandon. He gets his horses into good position. These two competed in their most recent starts, kind of just a prep race for today. Johnny Gunn coming off that win in the Alberta Plainsman, where he was 10-1. So he was sent off at even odds in this race. And it is You Are Cut Off, went off at 7-2. You Are Cut Off going to come up with a nice race here. He's going to get the win here, 156-4. Johnny Gunn going to try to get him late, and they are going to be not separated by a whole lot at the end of it. Just a really nice move here by You Are Cut Off. Brandon Campbell driving him perfectly to the front. And that's the difference right here in the finish of this race. Johnny Gunn having to wait for room. You can see him sitting in third there. And he was able to get out of there eventually. Had to wait for the horse on the outside to tire. And he's now going to make that move. And that's him as he comes around horses to get to the outside. A little bit too late, though, unfortunately for him. Johnny Gunn finishing second best to You Are Cut Off. So those two renewing rivalries here this afternoon. Again, they are going to have a tall task in getting past first class horse, who will be your race favorite. We'll send things over to Crystal.
Thanks, Don, and it's a great introduction to just a few of the key players in today's feature races here today. Still so much more to come from Century Downs and our 90,000 Brad Gunn Stakes. Well, we've sure come a long way. So once nothing more than just a vision, now the dream has come to fruition, and it all happens here today at the beautiful Century Downs. So Don, so much to look forward to here, the big race coming up.
Very excited, and it's just a matter of moments now before they turn to the gates. So the horses have had their warm-ups. It's go time. So many veteran horses in here, you know, and so many veteran horsemen. They know what's at stake. The big, big favorite right now, as expected, number 6 first class horse. He's sitting on the tote board at 2-5. Not a big surprise there for anyone. Second favorite right now comes from the inside post position. That's Have Not Read It. That surprises me a little bit. The big strength of Have Not Read It is those final quarters. He's got a tremendous closing kick, and he has not finished out of the top three so far this year. Didn't race as a two-year-old, so this is all new to Have Not Read It. Second favorite on the board. All eyes here on number 6 first class horse. Again, the stakes are the track record for the three-year-olds, 154-1, overall record 152-3, and we're going to send it upstairs to track announcer Murray Slough.
Thank you, Don. Host 2, Chillin' Like a Villain, Bill Teange Jr. 3, Outlaw Deacon Jim with Paul Davies. 4, You Are Cut Off, Brandon Campbell. The 5, Pablo's First, J.F. Gagne. The favorite first class horse with Keith Clark. Host 7, Johnny Gunn, Jim Marino. Outside 8, Mike Sharona Blue Chip, Jerry Hudon. Trailing 9 with Flying Colors, Phil Giedrecht. And they're off in the Brad Gunn State Final. Leading out quickly there, Outlaw Deacon Jim gets the first call. But here comes first class horse rumbling up on the outside for Keith Clark. And no take back today to first class horse. He wants the front and he's gonna get it. No one wants to tussle with first class horse. He makes his way to the top. Outlaw Deacon Jim getting away second. Chilling Like a Villain from third. Have Not Read It has got away in fourth as they come off the turn. Then back to With Flying Colors from fifth. They pace the opening quarter as solid 27 seconds flat. Gapped out there, back there in sixth, as You Are Cut Off. Campbell's after him to keep up. Then you've got Pablo's First. with Johnny Gunn second to last. The trailer, My Shrona Blue Chip, fairly stretched out here in the Brad Gunn final. It's the first class horse doing the stretching as his first class horse on top in charge for Keith Clark. He maintains a two length advantage, racing from second. Outlaw Deacon Jim looking at the outside third, chilling like a villain, but he's not advancing. They go to half. 56-1, 29-1 in the second quarter. Back in fifth then on the inside, saving ground. It is with Flying Colors looking to the outside. You Are Cut Off. Pablo's first with traffic trouble. Nothing yet from Johnny Gunn. And trailer, My Shrona Blue Chip. They leave the 5-8s, head to the three quarters. It's first class horse on top in charge. Now here comes to the outside, Have Not Read It. That might be the challenger for first class horse. Have Not Read It to the outside second, inside third. Outlaw Deacon Jim way back to with Flying Colors and the rest of the field. It's a three horse breakaway here. Three quarters, 123-3, 27-2 third quarter. Track record in jeopardy. It is first class horse turning for home. He's got 2.5 on Have Not Read It. Back in third is Outlaw Deacon Jim, but cruising in an aptly named first class horse. He overpowers them in the Brad Gunn Stake Final. Second was Have Not Read It. Third, Outlaw Deacon Jim in a new track record time, 152-3. It was first class horse.
And that is why he dominates in Western Canada. He has fantastic horses and he doesn't fool around. Keith Clark with the winner, number six first class horse, right to the front and never looking back. You heard Murray Slough say it. Not only is that a record for the three-year-old colts, but a track record ties it of 152-3. So just a sensational effort by this three-year-old son of Western Terror. And you're going to see the move right off the gates. First class horse, Keith Clark, not wanting to worry about anybody else. When you're the best, you leave the rest in the dust. And that's exactly what he does. A nice move there by Outlaw Deacon Jim and Paul Davies to get a nice trip there from second, but first class horse able to clear as they straighten out in front of us for the first time. And from there they just kind of followed along. A little bit of a late threat from the one Have Not Read It with Kelly Hort tipping that Son of Dragon again out and maintaining his string of top three finishes. But really this race never in doubt, and the fractions just went the way Keith would have drawn it up. First quarter in 27 seconds. They get to the half in 56-1, so a little breather there, 29-1. It's the third quarter that separated the men from the boys. 123-3 to three quarters. That was a 27-2 third split. En route to a 152-3 clocking, 29 seconds. An exclamation point put on the end of it by first class horse, now with 13 wins lifetime from 16 starts, 8-9 so far this year. So first class horse continues his domination. We'll go to Jeff.
Well, Keith, right away, Outlaw Beacon Jim went to the front. You weren't having any part of that today.
Yeah, the place for him today was on the front. I thought it might be tougher to get him there, but things worked out okay.
To the half and 56-1, any concerns or do you just felt so comfortable?
No, I wanted to take him down there in pretty good shape. I didn't want anybody out brushing him late or anything like that, so I won a good even mile with him.
Keith, you just set a track record. Don, Keith Clark, and a horse that simply is first class.
You got that right. First class horse. Hey, sometimes you name them and it comes true. And first class horse doing exactly what everyone thought today. So ended up going off at 1-9. That is as low as track odds can be. This horse is going to return $2.10. So 5 cents on the dollar, doesn't get any lower than that. But he was expected to win here. His last start was, even though it was a third place finish, he paced an incredible last half time of 54-1. I don't think Keith at any point today was thinking that he was going to take back and see how the race unfolded. Keith has won a lot of races in front. It's sort of his office, I guess. And why not? When you've got the best horse, you just go to the front and let the cards fall where they may. And fall they did. Very nice effort, though, by the one, Have Not Read It. That's the horse that just broke his maiden 4 starts ago in the middle of June. So he's come a long way in a short time as he makes his stakes race here in 2015 a good one. Did finish second to Outlaw Deacon Jim and the Gordon Rumpel back in June, but for a horse that just has a couple of wins lifetime. Sensational. Here are the payouts for race number 7, the Brad Gunn Stakes, $2.20 for first class horse, paid more to place at $2.30. The one Have Not Read at $3.93, and the 3 Outlaw Deacon Jim completing the top three, the Triactor of 6-1-3, $30.30. The Exactor, to no one's surprise, returning $7.60. The Brad Gunn Stake, a very formful race going pretty much as everybody had anticipated that it would. So here's the complete order of finish. First class horse, Have Not Read It, Outlaw Deacon Jim, You Are Cut Off, finishing fourth, and Johnny Gunn rounding out the top five. Checks paid out to those top five. We're going to step away for just a moment, but don't go far. We have so much more to come here from beautiful Century Downs in Balzac, Alberta, right here on CTV.
Later, it's been a long journey, but finally horse racing is back in Calgary. Many people played a role in making it happen, and the horsemen couldn't be more grateful.
It's not much of a challenge at all. Ralph Klein destroying Duke Cigar tonight with driver George Vandenberg. Prime Time Scooter with Prime Time Klein in the bike will get it done with ease. Ralph Klein wins tonight impressively.
Another thrilling victory by the late, great Ralph Klein. And he knew a thing or two about winning. He was the Premier of Alberta for 14 years and one of the biggest supporters and fans of Alberta horse racing. And it's taken a lot of support, a lot of belief to get to where we are here today. And I think that we should just take a little trip down the road to Century.
A lot of Alberta horsemen sacrificed their lives here to keep racing going.
Most of the people that did is just because this is their life. Nobody went, you know, out of their way to be superheroes to stick with it. It's just, this is what we do, so we're gonna do it right till the dying end.
It's an accumulated bunch of people that seen a dream and kept the dream alive, and now it's becoming a reality. Max Gibb, Paul Reinfeld, Freddie Gillis, Shirley McClellan, she bent over backwards through a horse race in Alberta.
It's been a long, tough journey. Calgary's been without racing for almost a decade.
For the racing industry in Alberta, it is the biggest thing that's happened to us for many years. I'm proud of the industry. Premier Klein, he was the person who believed so strongly in this industry and what it contributed to the Alberta economy. And he loved racing as a sport. It has taken a lot of work by a lot of people and a lot of commitment.
The horsemen are thrilled, absolutely.
Century Downs is going to be the savior of the horse racing industry in Alberta.
The economic benefits are going to be unbelievable.
The trickle-down effect is huge. For racing to be reintroduced in this area, farms, farmers, tack shops, farrier supply shops are all going to benefit by us being here.
This is just a rejuvenation of an industry.
If it's what you love and it's all you know, there's no sacrifice too high to keep going with it.
The history still lives here, and now it's going to live forever here in Balzac, north of Calgary.
Such a beautiful feature. They talk about the rejuvenation of horse racing here in the Calgary area, and you can feel it, Don. I just look around and it's such a celebratory feeling among the race fans. The atmosphere is just electric here. So much excitement, and I have the feeling it's just the beginning. We're just getting started here today.
Absolutely. Well, it's been a long time coming. I mean, a lot of people just waiting for this moment, putting their lives almost on hold and yet soldiering on. So the stories of perseverance, of bravery, of courage, of everything else of these horsemen will shine through this afternoon. It's been a long haul. So let's meet the field. We have another great race coming up, the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stakes. And this is what we're looking at. Remember Terror from the inside post position. Brandon Campbell will drive. Firewatch, Brave Effort, Last Start, Travis Cullen in the bike, and there's That's Extra with Kelly Hort. From the center of the gate, Jerry Houdon will steer Beauty of Nature from post 4. Number 5, Wrap to Go with Jim Marino. And then it's Cam Finish and Phil Giesbrecht from post 6. The two outside, My Villa's on Fire and Jamie Gray and Keith Clark, going to try to take the second win on the afternoon with number 8, Blue Star Texas, challenging post position for that filly. We did have some eliminations for this race. My Villa's on Fire. This is post position 7 today for Jamie Gray. My Villa's on Fire, dominant as a 2-year-old. She was the champion 2-year-old filly in Alberta last year. She had a tough time so far this year, going 0-for-8. But you could say her best race so far was in her elimination. If you ever want to find an all-around horseman, it's Jamie Gray. He shoes them, he does everything. He drives, he trains, he's been around a long time. Jamie Gray knows his way to the winner's circle. There is absolutely no give up in that man in the bike right now. We'll take a look at That's Extra from post position number 3 today with Kelly Hort. That's Extra is coming off of a very nice win. Her lifetime mark of 156-2 in the elimination, and she was driven there by Kelly Hort. Kelly Hort has been just a sensational horseman too. We'll take a look at that elimination now. That's Extra is going to put up a big effort. She seized command early in this race. My Villa's on Fire was in front and then relinquished that lead, and sitting in second right now, Beauty of Nature, Remember Terror, going to rally from off of the pace to take the third and fourth spots to get into this final. But you can see Kelly Hort pretty much on cruise control right here with That's Extra. Again though, My Villa's on Fire, champion filly last year, and that was probably her best race so far. That's Extra taking new mark of 156-2. And there he is, Kelly Hort, now 49 years of age. A little flamboyant, a little showy, but you know what? He backs it up with results. Kelly Hort has done a lot on the Western Circuit. And we'll take a look at the next elimination, because we did have two. The other elimination was a little bit more intriguing, and this is going to be a long shot. Wrapped to go with Jim Marino in the bike. Sent off at 13-1, not expected to do anything. You can see she has to wait for room here, and she's going to ease around. That's Blue Star Texas in front with Keith Clark. Was sent off at 2-5 in this race. Actually, that's Phil Giesbrecht driving on this day. Keith Clark took the other stable horse to get into the elimination, or into the final. Blue Star Texas going to get a little wobbly down the stretch here, and look who's on the outside coming up with it. It's Wrapped to Go, Firewatch, another horse you have to consider, because she was parked out every step of the way there with Travis Cullen, still managed to finish in for second. So Wrapped to Go, what's she done for us lately? She was in a 6,000 claimer 2 starts ago, and now she's in the final of the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake. Amazing effort in her elimination, pacing to a life best of 155-2 off the strength of a 28-3 last quarter. She has all the momentum. You want to speak about momentum. Jim Marino in the bike, we've mentioned it already. He's just happy to be anywhere. Involved in an accident earlier in February. A lot of people didn't think that he would be here to drive in this race today. We're going to introduce the fourth member of our crew now, Shannon Sugar Doyle, racing analyst extraordinaire, standing beside Jim Marino, who has come a long way.
Right on. Thank you, Don. I am here with Jim, and what a remarkable recovery. Jim Marino, tell us about it. A few months ago, you're laid up and right back into big stakes action now. Tell us a little bit about the accident and maybe how you've come to be here today.
Yeah, we had a bad accident in January, and these things happen, and you know, I broke quite a few bones there and was laid up in the hospital and recovery and all that. And to get back racing at this level, it feels really good.
Yeah, okay, so to be back today with this Wrap to Go, second time out for you. She was just spectacular. This is third time. I'm expecting even better things for her today. Your thoughts on her last week?
She was really good last week, and of course she benefited from the trip. She got a lucky trip, and these are some really nice fillies out here, and to her to prove she's a good filly, she's going to beat them again.
Early speed battle last week helped your chances. Your thoughts this week? You're leaving post 5. That's a tricky spot to leave here at Century Downs.
It's always tricky, and once again, the whole trip I get is the key. So I'm going to need a little bit of luck and a little bit of horse, and maybe we can get there.
Jim Marino's thoughts on Wrap to Go. That's my top choice in this Rich Philly race. Best of luck to you, Jim, and thanks for doing this.
Thanks, Sugar.
Right on. Back to Don.
All right, Sugar, what an inspirational man, a great story. And you know, it's taken such a great community of believers and strength to get to where we are today. But none of that would have been possible without the initial passion of Dwight McClellan. Dwight was the driving force behind the original vision to rejuvenate horse racing here in central Alberta. He was a leader in the United Horsemen of Alberta until his passing in 2008. So as a tribute to his courage and to his strength, he will always be remembered along Dwight McClellan Trail that leads right here to the beautiful Century Downs, and it also leads to a brighter future in horse racing. And when you think of the future of horse racing, you have to start at the most exciting event of the year. It's the baby sale, the 2015 Asha Yearling Sale is fast approaching, coming up quickly here on September the 4th, and you'll find that at the Mega Dome in Old Alberta. So study your catalog and pick out your next future superstar. So on the other side of this commercial, we will come right back and meet the rest of our stars today.
Join us next Saturday at 5 p.m. for the 86th running of the Canadian Derby on CTV.
The Canadian Derby at Northlands Park, the biggest race day of the year in the thoroughbred world. That's where we're going to be. We sure hope that you will come and join us. We'll be on CTV live from 5 till 6. But here today, we're talking about the biggest day in the Alberta standardbred industry. And it continues with some more behind-the-scenes insight from a couple of pros. Sugar?
Right on. I'm here with Jerry Hudon. Jerry Hudon, got a value player here in Beauty of Nature. Just touch on her chances today. She raced well. She's probably never been better coming in.
Yeah, she raced really good last week. I was happy with her, took her back and raced her, and she was three deep around the last turn and fired down the lane. If she responds like that this week, I think I can get a chance to get some good money.
It is kind of tough to come from off the pace here at Century Downs. We've seen that through races on this young history of Century Downs. Coming wide out of this turn, I imagine that's what you're going to have to do. You're going to hope for a hot pace to chase. But tell us how hard it may be to come from off the pace in this.
Well, I mean, you get into this last turn and you're three deep. And yeah, actually, I didn't find it that bad. It's when you slingshot out of the turn, the horses on the rail have kind of give you open up two or three more on you. And it takes a little longer for you to get back into gear for the straightaway, and we kind of run out of time.
Okay, Jerry Hudon has won stake races in Alberta in the past at long odds, expected to be long odds here with Beauty of Nature. Long shot players will be following. Just one final thought on your chances today.
You know, if I'm in the top five, I'll be very happy with her. It all depends on what the trip does and how much speed we got in front of us.
Right on. Thanks for this, Jerry. Throwing a crystal.
Thanks so much, gentlemen. So, Jerry Hudon, a very familiar name in Alberta horse racing here, a classy, classy veteran. There's so much up-and-coming, exciting young talent, too, to look forward to for race fans. Travis Cullen, he has certainly been a force since his arrival here on the Alberta circuit. And together with the amazing filly Firewatch, I think they're going to be so tough in here. They're definitely consistent. They're on a roll, and they would love to add another stakes victory to their resume. And the fans are loving Firewatch here today. So I think we have an advantageous post position. We have a hot driver and a gorgeous filly to cheer for, but we definitely have work to do. We're up against some classy veterans here today, and certainly I think Firewatch is going to be a fan favorite to watch for. But I want to know who are you looking for today?
Longtime friend and colleague of Ralph Klein, Mr. George Vandenberg. Let's first talk about the amazing man.
Well, it's great to be here, and for the Century Downs to feature Ralph Klein is absolutely amazing. Ralph was a great premier to work with and to serve with. He loved Albertan, and he loved Albertans, and he loved horse racing too.
Now, you had the chance to compete in a bunch of charity races and very cold nights against Ralph. He definitely loved the sport.
Well, 2001, we started in December, and we raced every year in December for six following years. We had a lot of fun, and we raised some great money for some awesome charities.
George, enjoy your afternoon at the races.
Thanks, George.
Kelly Hort standing with me now, and his thoughts on That's Extra Extra. Big motor in this filly, Kelly.
Hey, Sugar, how you doing? Yeah, this is a real nice mare. She's had some tough times learning how to race. She's getting better all the time, and hopefully we'll get the right trip today and she can get a piece of it.
You made a big move near the halfway point last time out. Horses just couldn't pace with this filly. Lots of horsepower. That third quarter was just major.
She can pace with any of them here. That's for sure for a piece of it. You know, we're working on getting her settled down that she can carry that a little farther now. So hope today's the day.
Right on. Trip is key here, maybe for That's Extra. Any kind of early speed battles and her on a helmet, she will be dangerous in this Ralph Klein final. Best of luck, Kelly Hort. That's Extra.
Thanks, buddy.
And That's Extra sitting right now at 5-1. So if that's the one that you like, that's a $12 winner, and that could certainly be the horse for you. It's actually interesting to look at the tote board right now because it is number 2, Firewatch, who is a co-favorite with number 8, Blue Star Texas. Both of those fillies getting a lot of attention. Blue Star Texas is the track record holder for 3-year-old fillies, 154-4. Keith Clark beating his own track record with First Class Horse, renewing in the last race to Brad Gunn Stakes, going 52-3. It'll be Blue Star Texas to try to best her time. Let's meet these young ladies. Number 1, Remember Terror. This is a daughter of Western Terror. Again, 3 American breds in this field, and this is one of them. Brandon Campbell will pilot for trainer Lance Ward. Just 1 win so far in 16 starts. She's been plying her trade out at Fraser Downs mostly. Coming in from her elimination, she rallied from off of the pace to finish 4th, pacing her own mile in 157-3. She's got a great post, but at 22-1, that would be some kind of a major upset if Remember Terror found her way to the winner's circle here in the Ralph Klein. Starting beside her, the filly who is now the favorite at 7-5, this is Firewatch. Where did that last race come from? Now, she is all about speed. Daughter of Comistic, Travis Cullen, trains and drives. Just 1 win so far this year. She likes to go to the front, but last time she couldn't get there from the outside post position, had to pace the entire mile on the outside, and somehow finished a very game 2nd to Wrap to Go. Firewatch, much better draw for her here today. Number 3, That's Extra. Kelly Hort, confident, why not? She pays to a new mark of 156-2 in her elimination, holding off My Villa's on Fire. Now with 5 wins from 10 starts this year, this daughter of All-American native seems to be in her best form right now, and confidence is key with her. She's coming off of 3 wins in her last 4 starts. Starting beside her will be number 4, Beauty of Nature. There is Jerry Houdon. He trains this daughter of Comistic. Beauty of Nature, couple wins so far in the season. She is 3-14 lifetime, best mark of 157-4. She's going to have to pick it up a little bit. If the pace collapses into her, she can close quite a bit. She's had 2 outside draws her last 2 starts, so much better spot for her today. Post position 4, that is Beauty of Nature. From the 5 hole, Wrap to Go, daughter of Cam's Card Shark, with Jim Marino training and driving this horse, privately purchased after her last race on July the 19th, a condition claiming race where she finished 4th. For her new owner so far, she came back, finished 5th, and then followed that up with a win in her elimination, upsetting at 13-1 from off of the pace, pacing a last half in 57-1. That kind of closing speed going to be very useful here for Wrap to Go. Number 6 is Cam Finish. Phil Giesbrecht, new to the Alberta circuit, making a lot of waves. Keith Clark handing the lines to this competent young horseman, Cam Finish. Coming off of a 4th place finish to get into this final, was dismissed at 20-1 on that day. Probably needed that race. Hadn't seen action since the middle of July. 3 weeks between starts for Cam Finish. She would be an upsetter in this field, currently at 15-1. Here's the 7, My Villa's on Fire. Again, the champion 2-year-old filly. Off to just a slow start this year, still winless in 8 starts. But again, that race in the elimination, a portent for possible improvement. And she was sent off at 4-1 as well. Didn't have a great draw either. She came from 6-7. Today she will start from 7-8 and not the public's favorite, as she is 20-1. And here she is, your Century Downs 3-year-old track record filly holder. This is number 8, Blue Star Texas, with Keith Clark looking to dominate our afternoon program. Keith Clark sent Phil Giesbrecht behind the gate with this filly last time out at 2-5, and she did not get the win. Last quarter, only 30-1 on a mile of 156. Disappointing effort for her. But Papa's back in the bike today, Blue Star Texas. Probably the best price on the board you're ever going to see her in a long time, as she's sitting there at a relatively fat 2-1 post position. Going to be the challenging thing for Blue Star Texas to overcome in the Ralph Klein Breeder Stakes. And there they are, 8 of the finest 3-year-old fillies here in Alberta competing for $70,000. Who's it going to be? Have you picked your favorite yet? Will it be Firewatch? Right now, 7-5, the youngster Travis Cullen could get certainly one of his biggest wins to date. How about That's Extra? Kelly Hort, always confident when he sits behind a horse. There is Wrap to Go with Jim Marino. This would be a Cinderella story for him after the start to the year that he's had. And then Blue Star Texas, probably going to be challenging for her from the outside, but she has all kinds of talent and ability. We're getting very close to the start of this year's Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake, the inaugural edition. We will get to that after this short break. Don't go away. Well, you have joined us just in time. We are literally seconds away from a feature race here at the beautiful Century Downs Racetrack. We have the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake coming up, and Keith Clark has one stakes win already. Don, do you think he can make it another?
Well, I'm sure if you ask Keith Clark, he would tell you absolutely. He is the most confident person you're ever going to meet, and the stats prove it. He has, for many years, dominated this circuit. What does this race mean to us Albertans, the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake? I'll tell you, it means a lot. I was here for those years when Ralph got into the bike, and there was something about harness racing that he just fell in love with. And for the mayor of Calgary, future premier, to come to the races, everyone loved to see him, and he loved it too. He felt like he was among friends, and he was. And we will always remember Ralph Klein very fondly. Murray Slough, we will send things up to you as we get ready for the inaugural Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake.
Texas, Keith Clark. And the fillies now swing to the backstretch here. They're under starter's command. Favorite on the board continues to be 2, Firewatch here, as the field in motion now for this final of the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake. They're all set. It's post time. They're off. And pacing, Firewatch shooting out of there from post 2. Far outside, Blue Star Texas in between horses. Wrap to Go wants part of the early action. And it's going to be those 3 onto the opening turn. Firewatch takes no prisoners. She wants the front and she gets it for Cullen. Tucked into the 2-hole Wrap to Go. Finding a spot in third there was Blue Star Texas for Keith Clark. She got in front of Remember Terror, who's pacing in fourth. Back in fifth for That's Extra. And then you've got Beauty of Nature following in with Cam Finish. And My Villa's on Fire rides the tailboard. They go by the corner, 27-4. Firewatch controlling things on the top end. At 8-5, she's got control of the racetrack and her own destiny here for Cullen. Following in second is Wrap to Go. Staying in third, Blue Star Texas. She'll wait for racing room. Is tipping out fourth to roll is Remember Terror. Latching onto that cover and coming on with a friend to follow is That's Extra. Shuffle back inside, Beauty of Nature. Outside and seventh for My Villa's on Fire. And Cam Finish at the back. They went by the half, 57-3. Very sensible tempo here, 29-4, only in the second quarter. And it's Firewatch. She's got control here for Cullen. First over prompt to Remember Terror appears to be stalled. Up the inside and in the pocket there. Wrap to Go is the major danger. She's at the heels, at the wheels of the leader. Inside fourth for Blue Star Texas. Looking to go 3 wide possibly is That's Extra as they go by 3/4. 126-2. Cullen now steps on the gas with Firewatch, and she opens up 2. Wrap to Go trying to stay with her. Blue Star Texas all out on the inside third as these 2 break away. Firewatch and Wrap to Go into the stretch in the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake final. Firewatch finding more. Wrap to Go second. Blue Star Texas third. Firewatch is sprinting home a winner in the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stake final. Firewatch goes all the way. Second was Wrap to Go. Well back in third was Blue Star Texas. In 155 flat, it was Firewatch.
Just
just 1/5 of a second off of the three-year-old filly track record, 1:55, paced by number two Firewatch with the youngster Travis Cullen. He trains, he drives, he co-owns this daughter of Comistic, and what a thrilling moment for him. Right to the front, that has always been her strength. A parked out trip last time out, resulting in a very gallant second place effort. But today, no doubt about it, right from the open. When the gate swung open, she just seized command. It was post position, making all the difference for her as she springs off the gate and just does it on the front end. You can see Firewatch taking off quickly. Wrapped to go, going to situate herself very well in second, and that is going to be where she ultimately finishes. You can see on the outside as Blue Star Texas looking for a better spot in life, and she is going to end up finishing a little bit further back. It took her a while to get loose from traffic, but she will end up finishing exactly where she was able to get away in third. And that's what it looked like early on, and that's what it looked like when they crossed the finish line. Two Firewatch on top of the five Wrap to Go and the eight Blue Star Texas. You can see Blue Star Texas pacing all she can, and it just wasn't enough this afternoon. Firewatch actually opening up, and Wrap to Go with Jim Marino couldn't have asked for a better trip. Perfect pocket trip. She finished bravely in second, but there is no doubt who the best three-year-old filly in Alberta was today, and that is number two, Fire Watch, owned by Travis Cullen, Ronald Cullen, and Dwayne Taylor. So a little Manitoba pride going on here in Alberta with Fire Watch in the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stakes. That purse, $70,000, $35,000 goes right into the winning owner's pockets. This filly now sports a record of 8 wins from 17 lifetime starts. Jeff Robillard catching up with the winner.
Well, here's Firewatch and Travis Cullen. Travis, what's the strategy right from the get-go to get to the top?
Well, you know, I was actually planning on racing her off the pace because last week, you know, she had parked the whole mile, and she fought so hard last week to make this final. You know, she deserves this win in my eyes.
You own this horse, you train this horse, you drive this horse. What's next for this outstanding filly?
We're just racing her here in the stakes, you know. We're fighting away here, and she's racing great.
Travis, thanks for doing this. Don?
And that was an amazing finish there by certainly Travis Cullen. Lots of confidence there with Fire Watch and lots of opportunities for her here in Alberta. She doesn't really have to go too far away to make a lot of money. Like Travis said, so ambitious, so unbelievably brave in the elimination just to get here. Sent off at 7-2 on that day. Today, the public all over her as she was the race favorite at 4-5. Post position draw made a big difference with Blue Star Texas having to toil from post position number 8, but I don't know. Firewatch seemed to be much the best this afternoon, and it would have been maybe a little bit more interesting at the finish. Maybe not. Maybe the best filly just absolutely dominated. We'll send things out to Crystal.
She did absolutely dominate, Sugar. She was impressive. We've seen on her form she's always loved the front end, but then we saw a little bit of maturity. She showed some versatility coming off of it, but today it was not the case. It was pretty much a one-horse race.
It was all about Firewatch today. To come back off the trip she went last week, parking first up, a lot of young horses just cannot come back off a trip like that and show up like she did today. She is a really nice filly.
Absolutely, growing into herself, showing a ton of maturity, and wow, what a great job, trainer, driver, owner.
He does it all.
Did it all.
Yeah, he's the young gun in Western Canada. He is the dominant force right now, and he clicks here with Firewatch in a big way.
Kind of fantastic. We talk about the future being so bright here in horse racing. We're seeing the future stars of the sport here behind us with this gorgeous filly and with Travis as well. Don, what an exciting day.
An absolutely fantastic day. And how did it all happen? You know, it was decided very early in this race, and sometimes strategic position means everything. One of the best drivers here on the Western Circuit is Jim Marino. You're going to ride along the bike with him as we have an ISO on him with number 5 Wrap to Go. Jimmy urging his filly on. He knows that he's done everything he could to put her in the right spot. Just not going to be the best today. Wrap to Go finishing very well in for second, but second only. By then it was over. Firewatch just came to the finish. Firewatch took the Wild Rose earlier this year in June, so this is not her first stakes win. That was her first win of the year, but this will be her second career stakes victory here in 2015. We're going to step away from just a moment, but more to come as we wrap things up from Century Downs live on CTV. We'll be right back.
These two break away, Firewatch and Rap to Go into the stretch in the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stakes Final. Firewatch finding more, Rap to Go second, Blue Star Texas third. Firewatch is sprinting home a winner in the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stakes Final. Firewatch goes all the way. Second was Rap to Go. Well back in third was Blue Star Texas. In 155 flat, it was Firewatch.
An extraordinary victory to cap off a fantastic day. I'm here with winning trainer once again, trainer, owner, driver. Now that you've caught your breath, tell us about what an extraordinary trip.
I got to the front pretty easy, and the fractions worked out great. And she raced her heart out today, but more importantly, last week, just to make this race, she was parked the whole mile and raced great last week just to make this final.
So the victory today must be even sweeter, Travis. You said last year you got beat by just inches.
Yeah, last year I had rolling deep and I just got beat just by a nose, and you know, it was pretty special to win it this year.
So some sweet redemption for sure. And Travis, just thoughts on the great crowd here and your experience at the amazing Century Downs.
The fans are into the racing here. It's great, you know, it's a great racetrack and a great place for me to race. I love it here.
And they're loving you as well. And what an extraordinary performance. The future certainly is bright here at Century Downs. Congratulations, Travis, and thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Ice water in his veins. That young horseman, just absolutely calm, cool, and collected. Yes, the future indeed bright. Right here in Alberta, the payouts for the Ralph Klein Breeders' Stakes. Firewatch returning 390 to her fans. Rap to Go finishing in second, 350, 290, and Blue Star Texas rounding out the top three. The Triactor, 258, $35.20. Two and five, if you like that exactory, you got back $20. Not bad by anyone's standards, as Firewatch dominating here in the Ralph Klein as the public's favorite. Two on top of five and eight, and it was a good race. Getting it for fourth was the three. That's extra. My Villa's on fire with the final check, rounding out the 1-6, and Beauty of Nature finishing out at the bottom. So it was an amazing experience to come back here. I left Alberta a few years ago, and I'm proud to come back. I'm proud to have the opportunity to come back and see what has been built in my absence. With these two races under our belts today, it looks like nothing but clear skies. And you can't get a better blue sky than the one you find here in Alberta anywhere. Century Downs is here to stay. And I hope I get invited back time and time again, because it has been a fantastic day. Guys, sensational crowd, amazing racing. What more could you ask for?
I know, we have the picture perfect day, and I'm the thorn between two roses here, you guys. And hey, Jeff, I wanted to ask you said you caught up with Keith Clark just after the race. What do you have to say?
Well, when Keith pulled up beside me, he made it clear that after his horse went 152 and 3, he still had a lot of horse left.
Right, so maybe we'll watch for next time. Any surprises in the big race, Sugar? How was your experience today? First time on the CTV broadcast. You're great, my friend.
Always great to come back to Alberta here. I've had a great run here, 10 years. I got my start in Alberta. And, just to come back for a big day like today, big crowd, as you say, and nice horses on track. Yeah, it was a great day.
Absolutely, yeah. And great for you to see your friends again. So, Sugar, sure. A longtime member of the Standardbred family. And we invite you guys to join us, because we get to do this all again next week. It is Derby Day, the 86th annual. I'll be there. Dawn will be there. We'll make sure to invite Dawn. She's worried about being invited back. But we'll be back Saturday afternoon. We hope you'll join us for the one-hour broadcast starting at 5 p.m. Thanks for an extraordinary day. Thank you, guys. On behalf of our entire cast and crew, thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next weekend.
This program has been a presentation of Ground Thunder Entertainment, a division of Horse Racing Alberta.